getting outside of Chavez's left foot, getting his right foot outside the left foot of Chavez, so he's not getting hit square with a lot of these shots.
A little bit low from Chavez, and they touch gloves. I think there is a lot of respect amongst these two men. This is clearly what Pernell Whitaker has in mind. I don't really think that he has any thoughts at all about standing there and just duking it out with Chavez.
Well, they actually moved his left and cut Whitaker off.
Chavez has been a guy who historically has fought his best in the biggest fights, and of course this one arguably is the biggest one of his career. So Cortez with a little warning.
That Whitaker's stablemate at the time, Meldrick Taylor, was way ahead on points against Chavez before losing in a literally last-second knockout. Whitaker is doing a good job in his first round, at least, of him off, and if he allows Pernell Whitaker to do this, he'll do it as long as he can and be effective with it. Excellent round so far for Whitaker, and he's not running. He's standing in one spot long enough to punch, then getting out of there. This is effective movement. Look at how many right hands Barry Chavez is throwing, and very little in the way of lefts. Not able to crank up the left hooks.
And really not allowing Chavez to throw combinations at all. Chavez, one punch on occasion, but that's about it. Chavez's history is notorious body puncher with both hands.
The jab is really bothering Julio Cesar Chavez right now, even when it doesn't land.
And I think the movement might be bothering him a little bit too. As you pointed out, he's not just moving ahead and back. He's really moving to his right very effectively.
And here's where Chavez could work on the inside, but he's not doing a good job of working.
Good example right here, and you can see a good right hand from Whitaker. Chavez just following him. End of the third round, probably the most effective round of the fight for Pernell Whitaker. Back to the Allodome after this. And remember that it is Whitaker who's coming down and Chavez who's going up. So it was
Whitaker, of course, already at the welterweight champion, as you say, at that limit. By Chavez, but he's been reduced to landing that punch and always landing it as Whitaker is moving away from that punch. This has been an excellent round for Pernell Whitaker. He has dominated. Chavez looks off balance so far. He just can't seem to get his bearings, and he can't seem to get Whitaker square ahead of him. There's Chavez hitting on the break, which Whitaker was warned about earlier. It's been a clinic in questionable tactics so far.
But I think Whitaker is really frustrating Chavez. He's a pest. He's always got his hands different places. He's moving back, he's moving to the right, he's moving in on occasion. Chavez just doesn't know where to find it.
And throwing great combinations now, Pernell Whitaker. And Chavez's jab has just been unable to land. pushing Chavez back now.